Did you know that you could compress files on the iPad? You can even do this on the iPhone, but I'm going to show you on the iPad. Well, what do I mean by compress files? Well, you may be familiar with this on the Mac or even on Windows. What we're able to do is compress multiple files into a single file, into what is called a zip file, ZIP. And then instead of sending 10 files over to someone, what you're doing is you're sending a single file over to someone. And then what they can do is they can uncompress that. Now, you may be wondering why you may want to do this. Well, it's a little bit easier to send one file through the internet as opposed to 10 files. And also what it does is it makes it a little bit smaller depending on what type of file it is. As I mentioned, we've been able to do this on the Mac forever. And of course, we've been able to do this with Windows. Well, now we can also do it on the iPad. Let's see how we can compress and zip files on the iPad. Let's go over to my iPad. Now, if you're familiar with the Mac, the way that we would do this is we would go into a Finder window. Well, on the iPad, we don't have the Finder. But what we do have on the iPad is files. This is the iPad's version of the Finder, or if you're using Windows Explorer, this is the iPad version of Windows Explorer, not the browser. So I'm going to click on this, and what I'm able to do is view all of my different folders on the iPad, much like I can with the Finder, and much like I can with Windows Explorer. So I have this folder here in my desktop here called My Files. And in this folder here, what I have is a number of different files. I want to send this to someone. Well, instead of sending all 10 of these files, what I'm going to do is I'm going to compress them into a single file. It's going to make it a little bit smaller, and it's going to make it just a single file instead of 10 files. How do we do that? How do we select these and compress them? Well, all we need to do is just go up to the top here. You're going to see select. I have to select what I want to compress. So now I just tap on select here, and I can select all of the different files here. I have an iPad with a trackpad. I have an iPad Pro with a keyboard. So what I'm able to do is just select these. I just click on the first one, and then I swipe all the way down, and I go to the last one here. I hold down the Shift key, and I select it. And now all 10 of those are selected. So now what I want to do is I want to compress these into a single file. Well, on the iPad, what we do is we just long press on it to get to our contextual menu. So I long press on it here, and you're going to see I have compress. And what it'll do is it'll compress all 10 of these files into a single file. So let's go ahead and compress this. And now we see down at the bottom here, we have my archive zip. This is all 10 of those files into a single file. Now what I'm able to do is send this to someone, and then they're able to open it up. Now the zip file, you're going to see that this is a .zip. This has been around forever. So you don't have to worry about someone not being able to open it up. As long as they're using Windows or Unix or basically any modern operating system, they're going to be able to open it up just by double-clicking on it. Now, what you may want to do is rename it before you send it. Archive is kind of cryptic, I would say. Let's go and name it something else. So all I have to do is just long press on it, and then you're going to see rename. And I could even go as far as double click me to open. And now when I send it to someone, they're going to see that double click me to open it, and they're going to be able to open it up just by double clicking on it. So let's go ahead and hit return. And there's my file. So now I can drag this over to a mail message and send it. I could drag it to messages and send it. And the person that receives it is going to receive one file. They double click on it to open it up, and they're going to see all of the files. So let's go ahead and see how this works, how we open it up, how we decompress it. Again, all we have to do is just double click on it. So I just double click on it, and you're going to see I have my folder here, and it has all 10 of my items in there. So now that person who received it is able to look at each one of these individually. And again, you don't have to worry about the other person not being able to open it up. A zip file can be opened up on any modern operating system, including the iPad, of course, the iPhone, the Mac, Windows, and Unix. So that is how we can compress or combine and compress multiple files into a single file. Again, the reason why we may want to do this is if we're sending a lot of files, it might be easier to just compress them and send it as a single file. All the other person has to do is just double-click on it to open it up. This is all done through the Files app on the iPad. And a little bonus here, you can do this on the iPhone as well through the Files app. So that is how we can compress or combine and compress files on the iPad.